Welcome to this 10-minute lightning talk, Improve Your Cipher Performance with the Query Log Analyzer, presented by Keys Vector. You can now start, Keys.
Okay. In AFJ, it is possible. Yes, listen to me. It is possible to enable the query logging. So every query which you fire to this database can be logged in a query log file. And you see here below an example of a query log file. So every row is a query. And I built a tool in the AFJ desktop to analyze those queries, the query log analyzer. This is where you installed it, and you can start in the main screen. You see here on the top, choose file, and then you can upload your query log file there. And then you can press analyze file. And then you will see this result. This is kind of the summary screen which you use the most, and it is possible to and it's ordered by the most expensive query on top. So if you have troublesome queries, you see them directly here. There are more tools in this tool. So when you press filter, you can go to see only your query log lines from the query log. And in this screen, you can scroll to the right. It's a very long table. And you can also see there your parameters if you log them. It's also possible to hit highlight, and then you see your query in the log file highlighted. And you can press tab to jump to all the queries you have highlighted. In this way, you can see the context around your query, what was happening before your query was fired to the server and after, to see to have an idea about the load on the server. Or you can use the timeline to see your query when it's fired, or you can also use the timeline to put all the queries in this timeline to see when the server was heavy loaded or not. Before we explain more, I have to explain a little bit about query processing, the cipher query processing. There's always a two-phase process. There's a cipher planning phase, and that will give a physical execution plan that will then be executed in the cipher execution runtime. So it starts with the query string. That query string gets parsed to a logical plan, and the logical plan is created with the use of database statistics. And from that logical plan, a physical execution plan is created. And this physical execution plan is then created on the cipher executing runtime. At the same time, this physical execution plan is also cached in the query plan cache. So the next time you enter a new query string, which is the same as before, then you can get the physical execution plan from the query plan cache and then execute that in the cipher runtime. That saves an enormous amount of time. So it's very important, whatever you do with AFJ, that you use query parameters and use repeatable statements. So the query log analyzer can give insight in the cipher planning phase, in the cipher execution phase, and in the query log phase. So how about cipher planning? Basically here, I use it to check my parameter usage. So the first thing you can do, you can check the tool header. Here you see 1775 queries, and there are 302 distinct queries found, which is healthy. That means that the same query is fired several times. If it's the same, if you have 1775 queries and 1775 distinct queries, that's a sign that there's maybe a problem with parameter usage or that the queries are not repeatable. So, and after that, you can also check your problem queries to see if there are literals in the queries. It should be replaced by a parameter. So in the green example below, you see here dollar full name is a parameter. You can also check the planning time. And you see here an example of 593 milliseconds. If you hover over it, you will see also the minimum and average planning time. And you see if you can reuse the query from the query plan cache, it saves you a lot of time. This is just a long query example. Cipher execution. There are more columns in the main screen. And the cache hits give you information if the data can be read from memory, from cache, or is read from disk. And reading from disk is slower than reading from cache, of course. Another important one is average waiting. So that is the time which is used to wait for logs to be released by other transactions. So if you are having a big number here, then you should definitely check your locking the locking calls. And another thing about cipher execution is the memory footprint. So there's an average mem column, and this is the cumulative amount of memory used. It's not the max memory used, but it's the cumulative amount of memory used by a query. If this number is very high, then you know that this query is memory intensive, and also yeah, they'll probably lead to a lot of garbage collection stress on the server. Query load. Now, of course, I already mentioned about locking. So if queries are waiting for each other, it will also occupy query processing capacity. You see here, you can see locking in the highlights screen from the query log. And you can also see the concurrent load, just see what's happening around it. Or you can just use the timeline to check the concurrent load. And there can be a case that you have very big RESTful sets with streaming a lot of data. And I always say you should really check your functionality if you are sending megabytes of data back to your front-end application, for instance. So when you identify all those problems, then you may think about how can I make my queries faster. So here I have several query tuning tips. This is not all the query tuning tips there are, but the most important ones. First of all, when you do you develop against Naive JS, you should always use explain and profile to find the problems before you find it in the query log. So you have to check if the index are used or are there eager operations you don't want to. The bad things are node by label scan and all node scan, which was also an indicator that there is no index used if you expected to do there. So some things to check. Avoid Cartesian products, which is also important. There are some statements you can do. I want to highlight here the optional match. Sometimes I come to customers and I see multiple optional match after each other, and that is can give problems if each optional match can give an array of bounds back. And then you get the Cartesian products of those results. So you should use WIT and COLLECT and DISTINCT to reduce the intermediate results. And here, and if possible, use pattern comprehension, because that is much faster, and sometimes also you don't need an optional match at all. Another query tuning tip is that you should reduce the query working set as soon as possible. So to the left, you see all steps in the query, and the width of the gray area is the amount of rows the database engine has to process to solve your query. So you can think about, can I move a distinct up to an earlier point in the query, or can I move a limit to an earlier point in the query, or can I use collect on places in the query to reduce the amount of rows to be processed? Think about the Cartesian problem. And then your query plan should look like this. That's interesting. That's fine.
Seems
is
like
it still works.
It is coming back.
Okay. It's there again. Okay. Almost
okay.
There.
Now we see it.
Okay. So, and another thing about creativity is to think about the query execution. What are you sending? What kinds of statements are you sending to the Naive JS server? You see here to the left a bad example where you put a lot of merges and in one statement, and this is totally not a repeatable statement. You should do you should fire the statement to the right multiple times to get it done. An extension of it is that you you can also reduce the amount of statements you send to the Naive JS by using batch statements. So here an example. For every entry in the list of authors and books, I fire a statement to Naive.js. I use parameters, which is very good. And then you see, and just fire the cipher statement. You can speed it up by using batching. instead of one set of author and book title, you set a complete set of records as an input list to Cypher. And then you do unwind, in this case, input list as row, and then you can use it to create the structures you want. This will speed up your write execution a lot. This is also used, for instance, in apex.iterate under the hood. When you use the config parameter, iterate list is true. And also Kettle notes about this approach. Now, this tool is meant to be used during development and testing. And sometimes I come to customers and they have problems in production and I want to use the tool, then it's not possible to get the query log file because of the sensitive data in it. So there's also another option to run a shell script if you have a query prompt to get the most 10 expensive queries from the query query. There's also a next version coming. And it is supporting version 4 of the native database. So it supports the multi-database. And you can also connect to the database and you get the current queries. And you can also see the query results. And from all the query interfaces, you can also do an explain plan. So this is still in the development. It's not there yet. But you see here the main screen for the new version, where you can see there's a database in it. You can see here the current queries, just like common queries in the Node.js browser. But also you can fire it per database, and you can also ask for the query stats, which is a functionality in Node.js, which is very neat. It's in memory, and it keeps only the latest 8,000 something invocations, and then you can get some stats from it. It's which you can just use without using the query log at all. And of all those screens, there's an explain plan. This is still under development, and but yeah, you can then step through the plan and see what's happening. Here's some useful links. I will not mention them all because of the time, I think. Yeah. And now it's time for the Hunger Games. So I can read it for you, but you probably can read it also. It's now time for question and answer. So I can read it for you.
Please, do you see, I don't see any questions.
Nope.
In the chat area. People do want to share your slides, so we will be posting these slides somewhere. We haven't figured out where yet, but you will be given the slides that Keys has presented. So just give everybody a few more minutes to answer these questions. Keys, at some point, if you have those links available, somebody's asking for them, we could put them in the chat.
Oh yeah,
I
can do that.
I don't know if you can do that without...
I just... go out of the full screen mode. I can.
Why don't we give everybody another minute to answer the questions, and then
I will do it at the end.
There's a question here from Ravi.
Yeah.
Can we do alerts for long performing queries?
I don't think there's alerts on it. The query logging is just the query can be logged after the query is executed. What you can do with the query log, however, is to put a threshold on the time. So if you say if the query log threshold, I want only to see the queries which takes more than 100 milliseconds or 1 second, for instance. And mm-hmm. then you filter, you get earlier the bad queries, and maybe you can put a monitoring on the file to see how that goes.
Mm-hmm.
And then monitoring, you can probably use an alert for that.
Okay. All right. Well, I think we're done for this session. Thank you, Keys, very much for presenting to us today. And if you could just put those three links in the chat area, I think that...
I will put it there.
Okay, great. Thank you very much, Keys.
The first two. And the lead one. So I'm ready.